Hey guys, welcome back to Fakes Gaming's Redstone Tutorials. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to build a super compact double piston extender. Well, horizontal double piston extender. So let's just see what this thing does. Come over here, click the button. It extends the block out. Let's go of the block. And then you click it again, and it extends in and takes a block. So if I had a nice little pretty wall right here, like so. As you can see, it's all flush, and then you click the button, and it pulls the block in. So let's just show you how to build it, and then I'm gonna show you some different ways of what you can use this for. Because I just don't wanna show you guys a thing and just go, oh, here you go, now figure out something to do with it. So this thing is extremely easy to build. So what we're gonna do is just put two blocks down like so, put a redstone dust on the back of this block, put a repeater going out from this block with the redstone dust on it, set it to 2 ticks delay. Next, we're going to take 2 sticky pistons out, put one on the back of right next to that redstone, one right here, so it looks like that. A redstone torch down here with a block on top, and we're done. Now we just put a button over here, and there we go. It's that easy to build. And this thing can also be tileable. I will show you how to do that down there. So here's some things I made. So like, let's say you have like a medieval castle and you don't want like glowstone or redstone. You kind of want to keep it that medieval feeling, like with torches and fire and all that good stuff. So here's a nice little lighting system. So I'll click this button. It opens up and lights it on fire. So for this, all you have to do is build the exact same thing I built over there. But this time, all you have to do is right next to the torch. Let's just go over to the one I built over here. So right next to the torch, we're going to put a block down with some dust on top of it. The dust should come on, and then we just take out a dispenser, and then we put a dispenser facing in towards the retracted block. And of course, we're gonna need netherrack for this as well. And since our flint and steel doesn't work yet in our dispensers, we're gonna have to use fire charges. I don't know when we're gonna get the flint and steel. We might not even get it until Xbox One, so, but yeah, that's it. Next, all you have to do is make sure there's a block on the opposite direction, so this hits the block and lights that on fire. So we'll extend it out. And then when it extends in, it lights it on fire. So that's how you make an awesome little medieval thing. Now, if you want to make multiple of these, I would probably wait till title update 13. Because for some reason, this thing gets messed up if there's multiple of them. You'll see, watch. I put a bunch of them together. Press this button. It retracts fine. The whole thing retracts fine, but watch when it extends. Actually, that time it extended pretty nicely too. So let's see. Tracks fine. There we go. See what I mean? The block is there, but it's not there. So look, if I put a block down right here, and then another block up here, it turns to stone. Now that's the problem. Title update 13 should hopefully fix all those piston bug fixes. So if you want to do multiple of them, I would probably wait till title update 13. Or you could just do it, and then once title update 13 hits, it'll fix itself. So the next one I built is the same exact thing, just the same exact double piston, yada yada yada, click the button. But inside here we have some hidden chests, so you can like hide the button, put it somewhere no one can find it, no one will know your chests are behind the wall right here, unless you have a friend that likes to just randomly dig in your house, which I would probably not let him in your house in the first place. But as you can see, we got some double chests in here. You can also put one down here, but I decided to put a lighting system there because, or else you'll be able to see that little redstone torch. So I like to keep a lamp there. But yeah, it's just the same exact thing. Just those two double pistons, and then you just put some chests on the side. That's another awesome little thing. And now for the tileable section. So watch, I'll click this button, and bam, instant light. All that lighting, all nicely done. And it goes up to 15, like, you know, any redstone dust, the furthest it goes is 15. So let's show you how to make this, so you can make it nice and tileable like this. So what I like to do is just make like a line. I guess you can go up to 15 depending. Oh, I'm at the back of the wall right here. This is the edge of the map. You know, I guess we're going this far then. So, I forgot to turn my notifications off too, but whatever. We're gonna put down 2 sets of sticky pistons like so. Now this block was just here in the beginning so we could get those back pistons in. So we're gonna delete those. We do not need these anymore. And we're gonna put blocks down right underneath this set. Next, we're gonna put some repeaters down, all set to 2 ticks delay. Then we're gonna hook it up with redstone dust. Like I said, you get a 15, it goes up to 15, and then anywhere beyond that, you're gonna have to put a repeater, and the repeater will make the other ones on a different setting, which I don't like, so I usually do it only to 15. Next, we're going to put blocks up all along the back of these sticky pistons right here. And we're going to put some more redstone dust all along that. We're going to come a block down, put some redstone dust going down a block. And then we're going to put a repeater right here. And then we're going to put... we're going to need torches, so... I put everything away. So we're going to put torches all in front of the sticky pistons. And then we're going to put blocks up above all these sticky pistons. Now, you could put whatever you want down here. For me, I put redstone lamps over there. But, I mean, you could put, you can put hidden chests in here and all that stuff. Like, if you want to do the same thing, like I said, you'll be able to see those redstone torches. But it's a cool way to make some hidden chests. So then all I do is I'll bring this down just 3 with an extra piece of redstone dust. Block up. Now, like I said, if you want to hide the button, just right here's your input block. Just put your repeater anywhere. Going this way, going this way. This is your input block right here. So I'm just going to put mine like right here in the front. We're going to put some blocks down right here. And then I'll click the button. It extends out, hides everything. It extends in and opens up everything. And there's your hidden chests and whatnot and whatever you have. So yeah, guys, that's how you build a really super compact, easy, horizontal, double piston, extending thingy. I'm sorry I made this video long, but like I said, I like to show you guys some things you could do with it. I don't want to just throw it out there and be like, okay, now you figure out things on your own. And also, my redstone challenge, which is right over there, is actually has this based on it. So this one was actually tricky. This one, this redstone challenge is pretty tricky, but that should be out sooner or later this week. But yeah, guys, that's how you build it. And if you enjoyed this video, leave it a like and subscribe to stay tuned with my newest videos. All right, guys, peace.